In the house, it's always cool. We're living a life where happiness rules. Call us the G-Force and we hope that you will stay.
Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Thanks for joining me today. Today we are talking all things wines, my favorite wines. It's the most highly requested video request that I get on my Instagram feed. So today I'm going to share my favorites with you. So pour yourself a glass and let's get started. I have a variety of price points that I'm sharing with you, and I'll go in no particular order. I have some notes here that I'm going to refer to so I don't miss anything. But basically, these are the wines that we drink on a regular basis. And when I do the features for you guys on Wine Down Wednesday on Instagram, these are usually the wines that I'm talking about. So I will start with Educated Guess. This is the one that you guys hear me refer to probably the most because we drink it a lot during the week. So I'll give everything a rating out of 5 stars, and I'll start with this one. I've given Educated Guess about a 3.8 rating. The reason we love it is because it's got a really creamy texture, low acidity, and delicious flavor. So this is one of those bottles that you can just kind of open and drink, even if maybe you're not having it with dinner, you want to have some friends over and, you know, sit down and have a chat over a bottle of wine. Educated Guess is the way to go. If you've got some time, you can decant it to let it open up a little bit, but if not, it's not gonna ruin the bottle by any means. So Educated Guess is $20 price point, 3.8 rating. Make sure you go give it a try. So next up on my list of favorites is the Mettler. And my husband actually turned me on to this one. It's a heavier cab, which we enjoy, and I give it a 4.2 rating. It's about a $20 price point. We really like the Mettler because it offers nice hints of spicy, oaky, tobacco-y flavors, and smooth tannins and a pretty velvety finish. Very robust bottle. Check it out. I think you'll love it. All right, next up is one of probably my favorites. If I had to pick like my top two, this one's gonna fall in that category. This is the Heinrich. This happens to be a bottle of the 2013, and I give the Heinrich a 4.7 out of 5 stars. It is just a really delicious wine. You're looking at about a $50 price point, but I absolutely love, love, love it because it offers the best of everything. Your fruits, your spice, your dark chocolate, super robust flavors on your palate. It's just a really wonderful wine. We drink it without food. We drink it with food. Can't say enough good things about it. It's one that I would gift to my friends for their birthdays or Christmas. And it's the type of bottle that I open when I'm having over my VIP guests. So make sure you go check it out. Okay, before I share this next bottle, I'm gonna have a little sip break and I'm gonna tell you about IFUCK. All right, so with IFUCK, I was recently introduced to this one by my friends at Total Wine, and it's actually a blend. We give it, I say we because we really like most of the same wines, but I give it a 3.6. It's about a $20 price point, and it's a great wine to try if you are new to reds and you're really not sure which direction you're gonna go in, because it's not as light as a Pinot Noir, but it's not quite as heavy as a cab. Very fruit forward, very flavorful. It's one that we enjoy. Like I said, every week, these are kind of the ones that we go through, except for the last one I'm gonna show you. But it's one that you'll wanna try. It's fun, and if you say it really fast, that's fun too. Okay, and last but not least, I save the best for last. My absolute number one favorite bottle of wine is the Farniente. This is one that I keep in our wine cooler, and I love this wine for so many reasons. So this is the Oakville 2013. 2012 was really good too. But this is the wine that is about, you're gonna pay about $120, sometimes $150 price point for this bottle. But it's amazing for so many reasons. So many reasons that I love this bottle, but For me, it's all about the experience. Farniente is super smooth, but it offers a massive experience of fruit and pepper and chocolate and all things wonderful about wine. I will say you want to open this bottle and decant it for 1 to 2 hours before you drink it. Let it open up, smell the aromas, take it in, and then you're gonna enjoy probably one of the best bottles you've ever tasted, in my humble opinion. But it's a fave. We don't drink it as often as we drink the others. Obviously, the price point is kind of up there, but it will not disappoint. Share it with your close friends and gift it to maybe really good clients or, you know, people that you want to share something really special with. And that's it, guys. These are my top fives. I really hope you enjoyed this wine review. And if you have any questions, leave them below. If you have any comments, leave them below. And don't forget to subscribe. Thanks for stopping by. Cheers.